Hello, web. I'm Empire's Chris Hewitt, and welcome back to Empire's Countdown of the 10 greatest moments in Steven Spielberg films. As ever, I am joined by Spielbergologists Ian Freer and Nick DeSemlian. And at number 7 is a moment from Spielberg's most sincere, most affecting, most profound movie, Schindler's List. And it's a moment from the liquidization of the ghetto sequence where Oscar Schindler spies a young girl in a bright red coat.
Yes, in black and white.
In a black and white film.
Yeah. So this is kind of the real turning point for the character. Up until this point, he's been an opportunist. And this is the kind of thing that sort of picks at his heart, and he kind of becomes this kind of a benevolent figure. But it doesn't really hit you over the head with that. It's kind of a very subtle way of introducing a kind of change of mind and change of heart of the character, I think. Mm. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's brilliantly done.
And Nick, you actually interviewed the young girl, didn't you?
I did. Olivia Dabrowska. She talked to Spielberg about E.T. He actually recommended to her that she not watch the film until she was 18, but she watched it too young and was kind of scarred by it. But a pretty amazing, contribution to cinema.
Yeah. It's about greatest moments, really, and I think this is an undeniably great moment.
It's a technical choice that has such an emotional wallop to it. Mm. It's an incredible thing.
Yeah, that little sliver of colour just haunts you forever. Yeah. So there we go, number 7, Schindler's List, the girl in the red coat. And at number 6, E.T. Phone Home. Except E.T. don't phone home at this point, E.T. ride bike over moon. This is the moment in E.T. the Extraterrestrial where E.T. and Elliot and pals suddenly find themselves flying through the air on their bikes. This is a wonderful moment, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, there's no Mac and me, but it's pretty good. it's an incredible sequence, and I really like how Elliot starts off being pretty scared and nervous, and going oh, and by the end it's just this joyous thing where he's letting out this whoop, and it's one of cinema's most iconic images.
Did you try to replicate it?
I didn't know.
Strap an ET toy into the basket of your bike, take off.
I should have.
Yeah.
Obviously, this is homaged in Naked Gun 2.5.
Oh, yes, it is, with Richard Griffiths in a wheelchair flying across the silhouette of the moon. It's brilliant.
Yeah, I've interviewed Dennis Muren about this a few times, and there was a lot of debate about whether he should pedal or not.
Oh, okay.
Because why would he need to pedal? He does pedal.
Yes.
But why would he need to pedal?
And, well, he wouldn't know that, would he?
No, but... No.
As far as he's concerned, he's still on road, I guess. Yeah. So.
And if we're keeping track of Spielberg themes, the exhilaration of flight is something that turns up a lot. It's in Hook, it's in 1941,
yes.
It's in some of the Indiana Jones movies, and this is the most
pure
it's not in the post, it's the most pure example. there is flight in the post, there's a scene on a plane, but it's not, this is the most pure example of his idea of flight as an escape and as a flight. It's very influenced by Disney's Peter Pan, I think, if you look at this.
Yeah, yeah. And the soaring John Williams... Oh,
the music in this scene is amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this inspired the greatest theme park ride of all time, the E.T. sequel, where you go to his home planet.
Yes.
And he says your name when you leave.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not very good.
So he would go, Nick.
Yeah, it's quite creepy.
Yeah.
Wow. Is this still going, this
yes,
thing?
Yeah. Still going.
I need to go to this thing. This is extraordinary. So there we go. Number 6 is the scene where Elliot... gets high, shall we say, and E.T. the Extraterrestrial. Don't do drugs, kids, and don't hook up with aliens with weird glowing fingers either. It's going to end a disaster. And number 5, speaking of aliens, it is Close Encounters of the Third Kind. And this is a really interesting scene. This is the abduction of young Barry.
Yes.
Ian.
Yes, this is where he gets kidnapped by the aliens, but there's a whole, they kind of turn all the electronics on his house, it all goes kind of batshit crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Just brilliantly orchestrated terror. You know, you think of Spielberg as a director of wonder, but this is him as a horror film director, and it's brilliant. It's so exciting and so scary. Yeah.
Is it his greatest use of light? Is it sort of the god light?
Yeah, that's the image that he picks. When he was asked by the French to pick a...
The French,
yeah.
they just went, Monsieur Spielberg!
Yeah, he was receiving an award in France, and they asked him to... They asked him to pick a moment that stand for his whole film,
right.
The whole career, and he picked the moment of Barry opening the door and all the orange godlight pouring in. That's the moment that he picked.
Yeah, it's one of the shots I think about when I think about Spielberg films,
maybe
because I've seen it in our magazine as well so much over the years. But this, you're right, because this is a film that's about so many things, but it's a very optimistic film, I think, ultimately. It's a film about obsession as well, but this is a terrifying sequence. I remember the first time I saw it, I was like, am I watching the right film?
Yeah. One of the interesting things about it is that some of the things you remember were shot after the shoot. They were kind of reshoots, as it were. So there's the moments where the screws come undone on the vents.
That's
and there's a moment where the camera was shot comes down the chimney and she puts her hand up the chimney. Oh. All that was done after the Prince of Photography. It's kind of, he had ideas later. And
then so he just felt it needed that little extra oomph to get over the line.
Yeah. And it's his classic theme, isn't it? It's extraordinary forces meeting ordinary people and that kind of juxtaposition, which he loves.
Given the aliens turn out to be benevolent, they're being a bit dickish in this. It's a better way to do it.
Yeah. They should put him in a bike and then just ride through, ride over the moon.
Just knock on the door.
Yeah. Say hello. Aliens. They're aliens. That's why they're aliens. Because they do alien things. There you go. Number five is a moment from Close Encounters where young Barry gets abducted. Absolutely terrifying. And that is it for this episode of our countdown of the top 10 Steven Spielberg moments. Thank you to Nick once again. Thank you to Ian. And join us next time as we get into the business end of the countdown with number 4, 3, and 2. I've been Chris Hewitt. Don't forget, of course, to subscribe to the Empire channel as well. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.